Isaiah chapter 57, verse 20 and 21 says this, "But the wicked are like the troubled sea, when it cannot rest, whose waters cast up mire and dirt. There is no peace, says my God, for the wicked." When I was about 8 or 9 years old, I took a quarter out of my piggy bank and took it to school so I could buy something. Not a big sum of money and not a big deal, except for the fact that my parents had a rule that we couldn't just spend our quarters any way we wanted. They were trying to teach us how to manage money and how to save for the future, so the rule was we had to ask before we spent. Now, in all likelihood, there's no way my mother would ever know that a quarter was missing from that piggy bank. But later that day, when I came home from school, the fact that I had done something I shouldn't made me feel a little restless. In fact, I started to wonder when the shoe would drop, and every word my parents spoke that evening. And every time they glanced at me, I was convinced that somehow they knew what I had done. Someone had told on me, or the guilt was simply written all over my face. Eventually, I couldn't handle it, and I told them what I did. Of course, I'm sure they laughed about it when I wasn't listening, because it was hardly the crime of the century. But that day, I learned an important lesson. A clean conscience is worth more than all the money in the world. And that's one of the lessons found in the 57th chapter of Isaiah. God says there is no peace for the wicked. At some point in everybody's life, they sense that something is wrong with their relationship to God. And that sets off a restlessness in the human heart. Sometimes we try to cover it up by telling ourselves it isn't real, or by keeping ourselves busy, or by keeping ourselves constantly amused. Or that, by comparison to other people's lives, we tell ourselves our flaws are really insignificant. But still, there's this restlessness that will not let us rest completely. And I've noticed that even people who claim they don't believe in God still experience that restlessness. Some of the world's most notable atheists give themselves away just by the frustration and anger they feel when the subject of God comes up. If God isn't real, then why get so worked up when you come across people who believe? They certainly don't get angry when they come across people who believe in flying saucers or Bigfoot, but in the face of claims about God, there's still a restlessness in their hearts. But it's not just the atheists who wrestle with this. Sometimes well-meaning Christians have trouble finding real peace in their own lives, and they experience a spiritual restlessness as well. And sometimes we actually know. If we're honest about it, we actually know what's causing that sense of restlessness. We try to convince ourselves that it's not a big deal, but it is. Not so much because of the sin itself, but because it's keeping us from having an open and honest relationship with God. You know, I'll never forget how good it felt to tell my parents I had broken their trust and dipped into that piggy bank. And thousands of times since, I've found that it works much the same way with God on the grown-up issues of real life. Keeping things honest and clean with God brings lasting peace of mind, and that gives us a better way to live.